Bishop Claude Griffith. The year was 1933. Wave radio had begun broadcasting, and a radio for the home cost around $50. America was at the lowest point of the Great Depression. President Franklin Delano Roosevelt signed the New Deal in an effort to lift the economy. Adolf Hitler had risen to power in Germany. Construction began on the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. A new car like the Plymouth Six cost around $450, and a can of Campbell's tomato soup cost 11 cents. Azusa Revival fires had spread throughout the country. More and more believers had embraced the oneness doctrine and baptism in Jesus' name. Apostolic Pentecostal churches were being planted everywhere. And in Louisville, Kentucky, in December of 1933, four spirit-filled believers were joining in prayer in the home of Brother William and Sister Irene Woods on Eddy Alley. They were led by Elder Claude Griffith, the founding father of what was then called Christ Temple Holiness Church. Services were held there until 1935. When they rented a small storefront at 15th and Madison Streets. Elder Griffith was a zealous leader and anointed preacher, and the congregation began to grow. Soon, Christ Temple moved to a storefront on 20th and Madison Streets. The sanctuary was very small, barely half the size of the stage we have now. There was just enough room for a pulpit, upright piano, a stove for heat, and a few pews. Elder Griffith was inspired to build a church as the congregation expanded. Christ Temple purchased a lot at 1942 Cedar Street. World War II had begun, and building materials were nearly impossible to obtain. But God had a blessing for Christ Temple. Deacon James Rakes, a member of the church, worked at Reynolds Aluminum Company. He told his supervisor about the building materials problem. Word spread to company officials, and a meeting was held with Elder Griffith. God put it into the hearts of the Reynolds executives to donate all of the necessary materials needed to construct the first all-aluminum church in the United States. The new building was dedicated on December 19, 1948, and formally named Christ Temple. Throughout the 1950s, the presence of God's Spirit continued to move mightily. Many souls were baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost. In 1958, Elder Griffith was promoted to the office of bishop by leaders of the Pentecostal Churches of the Apostolic Faith, now known as PCAFI, and he sent out ministers from Christ Temple to plant new churches. God's message to the world was being spread as the result of prayer meetings in a little house on Eddy Alley. On March 12, 1962, Bishop Griffith passed from this life. His zeal and vision laid a solid foundation for the exponential expansion, anointed ministry, and commitment to service that Christ Temple would exemplify for the decades to come.
On Sunday, December 9, 1962, District Elder Robert L. Little of Connellsville, Pennsylvania, was installed as Christ Temple's new pastor. Elder Little was a phenomenal, inspired, anointed teacher of the Word of God and was graciously received by our church family. Many were drawn to the ministry by his godly demeanor. Within weeks after his installation as pastor, many were baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Spirit. There was a forward surge in membership within the first year. The church family needed a bigger home. In 1963, Christ Temple acquired a much larger facility with better accommodations at 3918 West Broadway Street. Bishop Little led the Christ Temple membership into the new edifice in May 1964. The new sanctuary had a balcony, annex, and the facility was complete with a large dining hall, kitchen, offices, classrooms, and a nursery. For the next decade at the 3918 West Broadway location, Bishop Little continued to build the church with innovative programs for outreach. The gospel was heralded via radio. The youth ministry was started, complete with bus transportation for neighborhood children to attend Sunday school. Bishop Little had a passion for foreign missions and traveled abroad to minister to those in underserved countries. During his years as pastor, many struggling pastors and churches in the U.S., Africa, and South America were supported by Christ Temple. Once again, due to fast-paced growth, our 39th and Broadway home began to burst at the seams. Architectural plans were drawn to reconstruct parts of the building to accommodate the membership. However, we soon heard about an ideal property owned by the Catholic Sisters of Loretto that was up for sale. On 45th and Broadway Street sat 4.5 acres of land, which included a spacious brick building that had been a girls' high school, a cafeteria with classrooms on the second floor, a 32-room mansion, and a smaller house with several bedrooms. It was the supreme space for a bustling congregation with an ever-expanding vision, and Christ Temple soon took ownership. Major renovations were made to convert the school gymnasium into a 1,300-seat sanctuary for worship. Much of the work was done voluntarily by members of our brotherhood led by Deacon Robert Orndorff. In May 1974, Bishop Robert L. Little and the Christ Temple family marched from their old location into their new church home. The property was paid in full within 15 years. Bishop Little led Christ Temple Apostolic Church with redoubtable Bible teaching and upheld the unwavering standard of holiness for 30 years. He departed this life on Sunday, May 10, 1992.
Bishop Dr. Michael E. Ford, Sr. In his beginning years at Christ Temple Apostolic Church, then Brother Michael Ford served as a van driver and Sunday school teacher and conducted street meetings and outreach campaigns. He was a volunteer with the Willing Workers Auxiliary, who did odd jobs around the church and at the saints' homes. Elder Ford answered the call to preach the gospel, served as praise service leader, and fulfilled any order or request from his beloved teacher and pastor, Bishop Little.
Power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood. Praise the Lord. The Pentecostal power hour is on the air. The membership of Christ Temple Apostolic Church invite you to share in the worship service. It is hoped that as you listen to the songs, testimonies, and the message of our pastor, Bishop Robert L. Little, your burdens will be lighter and you will be inspired to come to Jesus. So come with us and feel free to join in with us as we lift up the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, there is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power.
He warm-heartedly shared the experience of being called upon to extend the altar call after Bishop Little's Sunday morning messages and encouraged young ministers and workers to always be ready when called. By unanimous vote, then District Elder Michael E. Ford Sr. was elected the new pastor and was officially installed on June 10, 1992. A new era in the history of Christ Temple was about to begin. He supervised many major projects and renovations to the sanctuary and church campus. A lover of music, Bishop Ford founded the Christ Temple Anointed Mass Choir. Bishop faithfully led our church with his practical application to teaching God's word, visionary influence, and with a full heart for service and hospitality. Bishop Ford and Christ Temple continue to support global missions by planting 39 churches as an extension of Christ Temple Christian Life Center in Kenya, East Africa, and established 3 primary schools. A girls' dormitory is now dedicated to his late wife, Wanda Marie Ford. The Mum Wanda Dormitory for Girls is housing for students of the St. Sheila Joy Academy Boarding School. A mechanical well that pumps fresh water for the students is on the campus. That's a project that was so important to him to complete. He traveled extensively to help spread the gospel in Kenya, Tanzania, England, Rome, Haiti, Russia, and Israel. His God-inspired messages made global reach through various media platforms, including the House of Miracles television broadcast, YouTube, and Facebook.
But Jesus don't see like we see, because Jesus has the ability to exist in 3 dimensions, in 3 different matrices. The Bible says that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. We are confined to today. We hope to get to our forevermore, but the God you serve can step over into yesterday and be in today and be in your forevermores at the very same time. He knew that it wasn't as bad as it looked, because he can step back into your yesterday and some stuff that was broken and some stuff that was lost and some stuff that was torn up. God said, I can fix it. And by the time I get back over to your presence, it's going to be all right. I said, it's going to be all right.
Bishop Ford served diligently in many roles for the PCAFI. This list of roles include photographer, editor-in-chief of the monthly publication, The Voice in the Wilderness, district elder, diocesan bishop of the state of Kentucky, and planted 7 churches in Kentucky, tri-state youth president, council bishop of the tri-state council that comprises the states of Kentucky, Ohio, and West Virginia, bishop of protocol, diocesan bishop over the military diocese, general treasurer on the executive board of bishops, then second assistant presiding bishop. Bishop Ford was consecrated as assistant presiding bishop of the Pentecostal Churches of the Apostolic Faith International Incorporated at the 60th Holy Convocation and served faithfully until his transition. Bishop Ford Sr. served so tirelessly and selflessly and with relentless compassion as the senior pastor of Christ Temple for 28 years until his transition on October 30th, 2020. He earned a doctoral degree in divinity and was a published author. He made visits to the sick and bereaved and the incarcerated. He blessed our babies, eulogized our deceased loved ones. He married couples and spent countless hours counseling at the beck and call of God's people. He was truly a servant with a heart after God for the people of God.
Bishop Michael E. Ford Jr. is the son of the late Bishop Dr. Michael E. Ford Sr. and is a son of Christ Temple, born and raised. In his early years, he served as choir president, Children Against Negativity director, and as third assistant pastor to Bishop Ford Sr. On November 29, 2020, the membership elected Bishop Michael E. Ford Jr. as senior pastor of Christ Temple to succeed his late father. Since his installation, Bishop Ford Jr. has introduced new ministry components to propel our church forward. The Campus Development Team, All Day Everywhere Church, the Council of Men, Kingdom Women, Neighborhood Church, the Pastoral Care Team, Temple Academy, Anna and Simeon Prayer Ministry, and the Connect Team, to name a few, have been commissioned to serve our members and their families, our community, and the world. Many will eat from the tree of Christ Temple. In 2007, Bishop Ford was tasked with directing the Christ Temple International Ministries in Kenya and Tanzania, East Africa, which over the years birthed 31 churches, a 600-seat sanctuary and headquarters, 3 primary and secondary school campuses, 3 student dormitories, 8 church campuses, and 1 pastoral parsonage. As senior pastor of CTCLC, he challenges the members that the church is not a building with 4 walls, but that we are the church, discovering our kingdom purpose. He also currently serves as the convention manager for the Pentecostal Churches of the Apostolic Faith International and as executive director on the staff of Presiding Bishop Lambert W. Gates Sr. Bishop Ford has dedicated his time and energy to advancing God's kingdom. His passion is for souls to be born into the kingdom of God and that all will prepare for the return of Jesus Christ. Christ Temple Christian Life Center continues to be a beacon of light and a ray of hope in Louisville's West End community, creating renaissance. Bishop Claude Griffith, Bishop Robert Lincoln Little, Bishop Dr. Michael E. Ford Sr., and Bishop Michael E. Ford Jr., 4 exceptional, anointed, unprecedented pastors in 90 years, all designated by God for the appointed time. Each one unique, exceptional, and progressively unparalleled in their own right. We honor the legacy and the leadership of Christ Temple Christian Life Center, as well as the entire membership for these past 90 years. And we are excited to be celebrating God's faithfulness in the past, present, and on to glory.